Isang mapagpalang araw po sa inyong lahat, mga kapatid sa Panginoon, at sa lahat ng kaibigan natin na sumusubaybay dito sa Evangelicals Today Radio TV sa Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, at kung saan man po kayo bahagi ng mundo. Ngayon ay inaalala natin, ito po ay Holy Week. Inaalala natin ang sakripisyo ng ating Panginoong Jesucristo. Inaalala po natin ang Passion of the Christ, but we also remember the glorious resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. We praise God that Jesus is alive forevermore. He is alive in my heart. He is alive in your heart. He is alive in the church. And we worship and we praise the living God today. Ngayong araw pong ito, sa ating pag-aalaala ng kamatayan, pagkabuhay ng ating Panginoong Jesucristo, amin pong pinipicture ang isang worship band. Kaya samahan po ninyo kami sa ating pagsamba at pag-aalala sa araw na ito. Sa pangalan po ni Bishop Ephraim Tendero at si Maloy Salumbides, ito po si Bishop Noel Pantoja.
When Jesus died on the cross, God gave us the best of the best of the best. That's why Apostle Paul said in 2 Corinthians 9:15, "Thanks be to God for His inexpressible gift." There are so many reasons why we can say Jesus is the best of the best of the best that God gave us. Allow me to share at least 10. Una, sinless God died for our sins. 2 Corinthians 5:21, "For our sake He made Him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in Him we might become the righteousness of God." We receive His righteousness and He takes away our sinfulness. Number two, we are not worthy. Romans chapter 5, verse 7 and 8, "For no one will scarcely die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person one would dare even to die. But God shows His love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Hindi man karapat dapat ibinigay niya ang kanyang buhay sa atin. At pangatlo, He paid a precious and infinite price. 1 Peter 1:18 and 19, "Knowing that you were ransomed from the futile ways inherited from your forefathers, not with perishable things such as silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, like that of a lamb without blemish." Mas mahalaga pa kaysa ginto at mga pilak ang ibinigay na bayad ni Jesus para sa atin. That's why Charles Wesley was able to compose that song, "Amazing Love, How Can It Be That Thou, My God, Should Die For Me?" And because He died for us, number four, He released us from condemnation. Romans chapter 8, verse 1, "There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus." And now, because we are in Him, we partake the divine nature. 2 Peter 1, verse 3 and 4, "His divine power has granted to us all things, so that through them you may become partakers of the divine nature, having escaped from the corruption that is in the world because of sinful desire." Meron tayong bagong pagkatao. We have that divine nature. Ang divine person, nature of God, is now residing in us. And then we become a new creation. 2 Corinthians 5:17, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come." And then number seven, "Even when we were dead in our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up with Him, and seated us with Him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus." That is made possible because we become a child of God. John 1:12. But to all who did receive him, who believe in his name, he gave them the right to become children of God. At pangsiyam, now we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19 and 20. Or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God? You are not your own, for you were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body. And finally, we become citizens of heaven. Philippians 3:20. But our citizenship is in heaven, and from it we await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our lowly bodies to be like his glorious body by the power that enables him even to subject all things to himself. With all of these reasons, walang pagdududa na he gave us the best of the best of the best. Ano ang dapat nating maging response? Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. The Apostle Paul said, I appeal to you therefore, brothers, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good, acceptable, and perfect. We owe everything from God. Ang dapat po naging tugon natin ay ating ngayong ipagkaloob at isuko ang ating buhay sa Kanya bilang isang haing buhay, at tayo ay magkaroon ng pagtanaw ng utang na loob, pagpapasalamat for giving us the best of the best of the best. Thanks be to God for His indescribable, inexpressible gift. At tayo ay magpuri at magpasalamat sa Kanya.
Salamat po sa napapanahon at pinagpalang mensahe na yan, Bishop F. Ngayon nga po, mga kaibigan at kapatid, ay ating pong tinatampok ang isang napakahusay na worship band. Bisita po natin ngayon ay si Harold Heisen. He graduated summa cum laude from Berklee College. Wow! Saludo tayo dito. At he holds Berklee College of Music and holds master's degree in digital media and media production from the University of Valley Forge. He is a member of the national pop rock group Shamrock and Christian worship band Glory Fall. Harold, mga kapatid, is an active educator. He conducts drum clinics throughout the Philippines, and he is also faculty member at the University of Santo Tomas, where he designed the first drum set degree program in the country. Wow! Awesome! And Silin also, Silin Heisen, is one of the vocalists of Glory Fall, married to Harold, and she also helps the media works of the band, like being the photographer and designing their album cover. She's wife, mother, singer, worship leader, music teacher, and a photographer. Brothers and sisters, let's welcome Harold and Silin Heisen. Hi, Harold and Silin.
Hello, Bishop.
Bumati naman kayo. Bumati naman kayo.
Hello po. Welcome. Thank you for joining us today. It's an honor to be here.
Yes. Welcome to the show, and we're excited for what God has got in store today.
Amen. Amen. Well, it's really hard to comprehend the love of God to us. Harold and Silin, tell us, paano ba nag-sink in sa inyo ang pagmamahal ng Diyos? Paano ninyo nakilala ang ating Panginoong Jesucristo? Please tell us.
I met the Lord when I was in fourth grade. Mm-hmm. I went to school in Manila Christian Day School. It's Foursquare, under Foursquare Church, also in Manila. And mm-hmm. I grew up in a Christian home. But we know na hindi dahil Kristiyano yung pamilyang kinalakihan natin ay saved na tayo. So, the Lord made me aware of that. Klaro po sa akin yun nung lumalaki ako. So, praise God for that experience. And tama po yung sinabi ninyo, you know, it's hard to comprehend yung perfect love ni Jesus sa atin, especially tayong makasalanang mga tao. Sometimes you wonder, how can He love me that much? So, ako personally, how I'm able to understand, it takes faith po talaga with the help of the Holy Spirit to help me accept and receive that perfect love, and also spending time in the Word so that I will be reminded of the love of God for me.
Oh, thank you, Silent. And how about you, Harold? How did you meet and when did you meet the Lord Jesus Christ in your life?
I was about 9 years old. Mm-hmm. I'm a child. My parents were missionaries, so I'm a missionary child. And I actually grew up between Malaysia and the Philippines. And it was similar to what Silene's saying, is that you come to realize that your parents' faith doesn't, you know, you have to make a choice. You have to decide to own the faith or accept the faith or not. And so I was fortunate to come to know the Lord at a young age, and actually began becoming involved in worship ministry when I was 11, when Mount Pinatubo erupted. I would take a battery-operated keyboard to the Aitas that were displaced, and we would lead worship in the tent cities that they had all moved to back then. And
was that in Butolan? Butolan Zambales?
In Iba, or somewhere Iba, around
Iba Zambales. Wow. Yes, yeah. Yes.
So that's many, many, many years ago.
That's right. Well, I still remember that. I grew up in Ilonggo City, Zambales, so I very much know the place. And thank you for sharing. You know, I can identify with you. I met the Lord. I grew up myself in a Christian home. My parents were pastor and missionaries also. But you're right. It's got to be a personal encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ and a personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, many people, especially young people, they know Glory Fall. Huh? And tell us about Glory Fall band, and paano kayo naging part nitong worship team na ito?
I think it started with my brother and myself. I had already moved back to the Philippines. And I think many people go through this point in life somewhere, maybe a little bit after college, where you start to wonder, what am I doing? You know, I did this degree, I did what I'm supposed to do, and now what is God calling me to do? And that's kind of where, like, I started to feel like, you know, God sometimes makes things unsettled for us, you know, kind of kicks us out of the nest in that way. And I started to feel that way. And my brother happened to approach me and say, hey, I feel like God might be leading us to, you know, get into or get involved with worship and helping worship teams. Really, the goal of Glory Fall, how it started, was to help train and equip worship teams so that the churches or the whole body can benefit from it. And one thing led into another, that we still do training. It's a major part of everything that we do, but it went into worship writing Tagalog worship, online, like now doing Zoom master classes to try to help. Always the idea is to help the local body in whatever way, as that changes over time, I guess.
Wow. Silene, tell us, ano yung mga Tagalog, the most popular Tagalog music that you have introduced to the Philippines as Glory Fall Band? Ano ba yung mga music na yan?
One of the songs that I can think on the top of my head is the Ang Iyong Salita. Mm-hmm. It's an upbeat song, and it talks about, well, the promises of God, that the word of God is true and alive, and that it's full of promises to His children. Let's say some of the lines. And then, so one of the other thing is Dakilang Panginoon.
That she actually wrote.
Yes. Wow.
So, Dakilang Panginoon is, I guess, born out of parang desire to write a song that is solely focused on God. Karamihan mm-hmm. po ng mga kanta or worship songs, you know, right now, parang it always involves us. me, I, you know, when really if you look closely, the word worship is parang solely focusing on God alone. So yun po yung heart behind the song, Dakilang Panginoon.
Amen, amen. And Harold, did you say that this is available in Spotify or iTunes? Where else can we find your music?
Yeah, Spotify, iTunes. We have a lot of lyric videos that are uploaded directly to Facebook because a lot of people want it hosted in Facebook, but then YouTube as well. So if you go there and you were to search for Ang Iyong Salita, Dakilang Panginoon, or Glory Fall, I'm sure, hopefully, many things will come up.
Amen. Well, I encourage all our viewers and our partners to look for this. And ako din, titignan ko ito mamaya pagkatapos ng programa. I'm excited about it. Pero recently, meron kayong naisulat na kanta na perfect for Holy Week. Ang title nito ay The Best. Ano ba ang ibig sabihin ng The Best? At tungkol saan ang kanta na ito, Silene and Harold?
Yeah, so I wrote it. I guess I'll kind of field the question. This song, I guess as a father, what I was going through, you know, being a father and thinking about many times we hear about the love of God, the love of, say, Jesus dying on the cross, but we sometimes maybe don't think about like what God gave. And it actually came out like looking at, like, if you look at John 3:16, if I can just read it quick, it's a verse that everyone knows, right? Probably most have memorized, but for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. And he didn't send his son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. And it's, how can we comprehend, you know, that's how the song opens. How can I comprehend that much of a love, you know, as a father to give your child for someone else, and for someone like Jesus being willing to die for us, knowing, I mean, that's what we're talking about is the love of God earlier, like how we can comprehend it, but knowing our shortcomings and still willing to take our place, and knowing that even once we knew him, we might still fail, and still willing to forgive and love unconditionally like that. It's something that when you think about it, I mean, I guess for human mindset, it's just unimaginable, might be a word that you could say.
Wow, the best. Napakaganda naman ng message nito, and that is true, Silene and Harold. Just to think about a father, just like you, I'm a father too. But God demonstrated his love when he sent Jesus Christ, and that is to die on the cross to save us from our sins. Talagang the best ang demonstration, the best love, and the best expression ng pag-ibig ng Panginoon sa atin. At ito nga ang sineselebrate natin. Now that this is, as we celebrate Holy Week ngayon, ano, and we are still navigating through the new normal, we are navigating through the difficulties and the hardships and the sufferings of many people because of the pandemic crisis. As worship leaders, Silene and Harold, how are you affected? What is the impact of the pandemic for you as worship leaders and in your music ministry right now?
Yeah, it's been a hard transition, I think, for all worship teams, because we've gone almost from like analog to digital would almost be the analogy, right? We went from, you know, being in face-to-face on Sunday morning to have to route something through a computer. And, you know, what now with spikes again, things kind of clamping down again, we're having to go back when we thought maybe we're not. And so I think one of the challenges has been just how do we achieve excellence? Because that's always a goal for a worship team, I think. When we talk with worship teams, when you speak to them, the heart of worship teams is to give the best to God. You know, we don't want to bring God, you know, poor quality, poor ability, poor singing. I mean, that's why we rehearse. And most worship teams, that's the intention. So it's hard. I think it's been hard to navigate that transition for most worship teams and churches, how to get from or how to bring things to digital and still have excellence.
Mm-hmm. I want to add to that, though.
Yes, please, Eileen.
You know, he mentioned about some of the challenges, which is definitely a lot. However, when at the beginning of quarantine, Glory Fall, we were doing an online broadcast where we do live worship, and I was doing behind the camera. I was helping with the camera and the lights and manning the computer, responding and reading the messages of people. But for me, seeing responses from people, say, from Italy and then Japan and then Middle East, and then all that, we are able to make that impact from this one small room.
In Antipolo.
In Antipolo. And so for me, that's, I was like, Lord, thank you. You know, so that's something that we could not have done, I guess, in a face-to-face.
Wow. Praise God. Praise God that the Lord is using you. And just like many other Christian worship leaders and artists, and all of us are affected by the pandemic, but we can still do our best, and we can still do excellence in leading people, teaching people, discipling people, and just leading people to worship the Lord Jesus Christ. And that is true, no? Dahil binigay ng Diyos ang best sa atin, dapat ang natural response din natin, ibigay natin yung best worship natin sa Panginoon, yung best service natin sa Panginoon, and the best of us, ibigay natin sa Panginoon. Now, meron ba kayong mai-re-recommend, Harold and Silene, anong mga playlist na pwedeng mapakinggan ng mga viewers and listeners natin ngayong pandemic at ngayong Holy Week?
So for Spotify, you can look for the playlist, This is Glory Fall, and you'll find in order based on Spotify, you know, the popular songs, and you could listen through. And I think there's over 4 hours of music there if you wanted to listen through the whole thing from Glory Fall. We've been around a long time. And then Silene has one.
Yes, I have two favorite ones on YouTube playlist. One is the Tagalog worship songs. So these are our original Tagalog worship songs from Glory Fall. I don't know how many songs are in there.
Almost 30
songs. And then another playlist is the Tagalog version worship. So baka po hindi ninyo alam, but Glory Fall, we do Tagalog versions of popular worship songs. So example, The Blessing, The Way, Waymaker.
Raise a Hallelujah.
Raise a Hallelujah, Holy Spirit. Mm. So Glory Fall translated them in Tagalog. So sa mga Tagalog speakers there and those who love to worship in their mother tongue, that's me. If you're like me.
Praise God. Well, I look forward one day, you know. Pero even right now, in our online conferences and meetings sa PCEC, I look forward to having you lead us in worship or perform for the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay ba, Silene and Harold?
Amen.
Silene and Harold, anong message ninyo sa mga fellow musicians ninyo? And not only to fellow musicians, but to the people that are reflecting, that are worshiping the living God, the living Jesus in this Holy Week. Anong message ninyo para sa kanila?
Just hunger after God. And he will speak to you. Mm-hmm. You will find him. And regardless of what we face, pandemic, not pandemic, it's still the same God. Amen. Yesterday, today, and forever. And he wants to move. Mm-hmm. He wants to bless. He wants to reveal love. And he wants to be a light in the darkness.
Amen. Guys, keep pressing on. I know these are hard times, but don't give up. Hang in there. I want to encourage you at this time of Holy Week and even being, I guess, at home and cannot go out. Use this time to be quiet before God, you know, and just be still and listen and see what he has to say. Take advantage of this time that things are not busy. and see, you'll be surprised about what he's going to say to you, about things mm-hmm. that he's going to reveal to you.
Amen. Amen. thank you for guesting Evangelicals Today Radio and TV, Herald and Silin. I look forward to listening to your music. Right after this program, I will check it on Spotify and iTunes. But thank you for blessing our viewers, the followers, young and old, as people reflect on the Holy Week. Perfect ang message niyo. I really like the verse 1, no? How can I comprehend your love for me? How can I know how much you gave for me? All that I have is all I have to give. All that I am is all you want from me. You gave the best of the best of the best of the best for me. You laid down all you had. You gave your everything. Wow. Abandoned and lonely, forsaken, betrayed, beaten, disfigured. But still, you chose me. Mga kapatid, mga kaibigan, the best po talaga ang ibinigay ng Panginoon sa atin. Di po ba the best talaga ang ating Panginoon? Tayo na mga hindi kaibig-ibig, makasalanan, lumayo, nagrebelde, nagkasala laban sa Kanya. Pero ganun pa man, inibig tayo ng Panginoon at ibinigay niya yung the best. Yung the best, ang kanyang bugtong na anak, ibinigay niya sa atin. So ang hinihintay po sa atin, mga kaibigan at kapatid ng sa Panginoon, ay ibigay din po natin yung best natin para sa Panginoon. Harold and Silin, I would like to pray for you. Thank you for blessing us with your presence, your testimony, and your music. I would like to pray right now for you. At gusto ko rin ipanalangin ang napakaraming mga tao na nag-aalaala ng Holy Week, remembering the sacrifice, the death, the burial, the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? And let's pray right now. Lord, thank you for the testimony of Harold and Silin. Thank you for giving them this gift to encourage people through their music. Thank you for the songs that they have written and they have composed. And thank you that thousands of people are being blessed. Thousands of people are being introduced to the Lord Jesus Christ because of this music. I pray that you would continually bless them. Pagpalain mo po ang mag-asawang ito, Panginoon, kasama ng kanilang band, kasama ng kanilang church, para patuloy mo po silang gamitin sa paglilid ng worship at ma-encourage, ma-exhort, at ma-proclaim ang pag-ibig ng Diyos, not only during Holy Week, but every day sa aming pag-worship. God, we pray for all the people in the Philippines, all the churches. We all are passing through a very dark tunnel, O God. Just like the Thursday, the Friday, and the Saturday, when the Lord Jesus Christ died at the cross of Calvary, when the Lord Jesus Christ was buried, O God. But thank you that on the third day, you rose again from the dead, like passing through a dark tunnel. But at the end of the tunnel is a victorious, a glorious resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. Salamat po sa pananampalataya namin yan, sa pag-asa namin, Panginoon. Ang aming Diyos ay buhay, makapangyarihan, nagmamahal. At kung naibigay niya nga ang the best sa amin, ang kanyang bugtong na anak, how much more, Lord, yung mga may sakit ngayon. We pray for your healing. Yung mga nawalan ng trabaho ngayon, Lord, we pray for the provision of the Lord God. You are Jehovah Jireh. You are Jehovah Rabba, O God. Bring healing, bring provision, at bring comfort, Panginoon, sa lahat ng mga nahihirapan ngayon. And thank you for the song. Thank you for the music. Thank you for this message today, O God. We praise you and thank you. We glorify you, our living Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
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 Thank you so much, Harold and Silene. Alam kong pinagpala po kayo sa araw na ito, mga kapatid. Ako po ay pinagpala na tayo ay na-remind na sa napakadilim na panahon na ito ng pandemic crisis, para pong ito yung Huwebes Santo at saka yung Good Friday at yung Black Saturday na tinatawag natin. Pero wag po tayong mawawala ng pag-asa. Ang ating pong pagdiriwang ng Holy Week ay nagtapos. Ang ating pong Panginoong Hesukristo ay nagtagumpay laban sa kasalanan, laban kay Satanas at sa lahat ng kasamaan, laban sa lahat ng masasama. At tayo po ay may kapatawaran ng kasalanan at tayo po ay may buhay na walang hanggan. At kung tayo rin po ay na kay Kristo, bagamat tayo'y makaranas ng kamatayan dito, ay makakaasa po tayo. Kung si Jesus Christ ay nag-resurrect from the dead, we will be resurrected from the dead. When the Lord Jesus Christ comes again, lahat po tayo, kasama ng lahat ng pumanaw, lahat ng mga tao na nauna sa atin, there will be a grand reunion in the air. There will be a grand reunion and we will be with Jesus, the living Savior, forever and ever. Happy Holy Week at happy Resurrection Sunday sa lahat po ng bumubuo ng PCEC Evangelicals Today Radio TV. Sa pangalan po ni Bishop Ephraim Tendero, si Maloy Salumbides, ito po si Bishop Noel Pantoja. Pagpalain po kayo ng ating Panginoong Hesukristo.